say thank you to Gerardo. Well, let me just say, it is good to be back in Arizona. And thank you all. There are so many. This is an extraordinary group of leaders. And I thank you all for the time that you have taken to be together, for us to have this. I love you back. Governor Lewis of the Gila River Indian Community, and all the elected leaders here today, Representative Gallego, who could not be with us, but Arizona, let's send him to the United States Senate. And let's send former Navajo Nation President Jonathan Nez. And let me say, it means so much to be back with the Gila River Indian community. Last summer, I became the first Vice President of the United States to visit this tribal nation. And I strongly believe that the relationship between tribal nations and the United States is sacred, and that we must honor tribal sovereignty, embrace our trust and treaty obligations, and ensure tribal self-determination. And it is my promise as President of the United States, I will defend those principles always. Before I continue, I will say a few words about Hurricane Milton, which has cut a path of devastation across Florida and follows closely, of course, on the heels of the damage caused by Hurricane Helene to communities across the Southeast. I know, as you do, that our heart goes out to everyone who has been impacted by these storms. Our administration has mobilized thousands of federal personnel across the region to work hand in hand with local and state officials to give folks the help they need. I have spoken with state, local officials, both Republican and Democrat, to let them know we will be with you every step of the way as you recover and rebuild. That is who we are. That is who we are. So moving forward, let me say that Arizona, look, we have just 26 days until Election Day. 26 days. And we are nearing the home stretch. And this will be a very tight race until the very end. And we are the underdog. We are the underdog. So we have some hard work ahead of us, but we like hard work. In 26 days, we will win. We will win. We will win. And y'all might have seen that just last night, Donald Trump officially ruled out any more debates. Now, I think it it's a disservice to the voters. I also think it's a pretty weak move. But even if he will not debate, the contrast in this election is already clear. This election is about two very different visions, two very different visions for our nation. One, his, focused on the past. The other, ours, focused on the future. Including being focused on the issues that matter most to working families across America, like bringing down the cost of living, investing in small businesses and entrepreneurs. Do we have any small businesses in the house? We believe in fighting to protect reproductive freedom. And we will always fight to keep our nation secure and honor our military service members. And so many others are the issues that matter to you and your families, which is why you have taken the time out of your very busy lives to be here this evening. But that is not what we hear from Donald Trump. We don't hear about these issues. Instead, from Donald Trump, it's the same old tired playbook. He has no plans, no plans for how he would address the needs of the American people. He is only focused on himself. Well, folks, it's time to turn the page. It's time to turn the page. And America is ready for a new way forward. For a new, optimistic generation of leadership for our country. Which is why, Arizona, which is why Democrats, Republicans, and independents are supporting our campaign. Because they know we need a president who works for all the American people. All the American people, because we know we have so much more in common than what separates us. And we are exhausted with those who would try and have us as Americans point fingers at each other. We're tired of that. And fighting on behalf of the American people has been the story of my entire career. I've only had in my career one client, the people. As a young courtroom prosecutor, I stood up for women and children against predators. As Attorney General of California, I took on the big banks, delivered $20 billion for middle-class families who faced foreclosure. I stood up for veterans and students being scammed. Being scammed by the big for-profit colleges. I stood up for workers being cheated out of their wages. I stood up for seniors facing elder abuse, and it is my pledge to you as President of the United States, I will always fight for all the American people. Together, we will build a brighter future for our nation. future where we build, for example, what I call an opportunity economy, where everyone has the ability to compete and have a real chance to succeed. Under my economic plan, we will bring down the cost of housing. Arizona, you know that's an issue we need to deal with. We will help first-time home buyers with their down payment, with $25,000 down payment assistance. We will help entrepreneurs start and grow small businesses, knowing you are the backbone of America's economy. We will expand health care in a way that makes Medicare cover home health care for seniors. Because we know it's just not right that people have to spend down all their money to qualify for Medicaid to be able to take care of what is basically about dignity when it comes to home health care. It's about dignity. And so part of my plan is to recognize you who are members of what we call the sandwich generation, who are taking care of your young children and your parents at the same time. Knowing what that does in terms of the emotional, the physical, the mental burden that you are carrying, just trying to take care of your family. And we need to have policies in our country that see you and lift you up, knowing it is a matter of dignity and just what is right. We will lower the cost on everything from healthcare to groceries, taking on, for example, the issue of corporate price gouging. I've done it before and I'm going to do it again. We will give a tax cut to 100 million Americans, including $6,000 during the first year of your child's life, to help you be able to buy a crib or a car seat or all the things you need at that critical stage of your child's development. And all of this is to say, I will always put middle-class families first. I come from the middle class. I come from the middle class. And I will never forget where I come from. Now, Donald Trump has a different plan. Just Google Project 2025. And I continue to say, I can't believe they put that in writing. You know, they published it, they bound it, and they handed it out. They're out of their minds. And it is a detailed, dangerous blueprint for what he will do if he is elected president again. Donald Trump will give billionaires and corporations massive tax cuts. Cut Social Security and Medicare is what he would do. And impose what I call a Trump sales tax, a 20% tax on everyday goods and necessities, which will cost, the economists have said, the average American family nearly $4,000 more a year. On top of this, Donald Trump intends to end the Affordable Care Act. Now, Arizona, I was a member of the United States Senate during that time, but during that time when he was president and kept trying to get rid of the Affordable Care Act. And I'm going to tell you about one particular night, which has a direct connection to all of you. So that one night, it was late in the night. They were trying to get rid of the Affordable Care Act again, and it required one more vote to keep it intact. And that vote was the late, great John McCain. a great American, a war hero, John McCain. And I'll never forget that night. So we're all standing in the chamber, and we're waiting. And then, you know, in the Senate chamber, there are these big wooden doors. And it was like out of a movie. The wooden doors broke open. And John McCain came walking into the well of the United States Senate and said, "No, you don't. No, you don't. No, you don't." But Donald Trump is trying to get rid of the Affordable Care Act still. And guess, here's the thing. He has no plan to replace it. Oh, you watched the debate. You watched the debate. So remember, he's got, quote, concepts of a plan. Concepts. Okay, so let's think about that. You know, I've said, because it's true, he is an unserious man. And the consequences of him ever being president again are brutally serious. Because think about this, concept of a plan. So he's basically going to threaten the health insurance of 45 million Americans based on a concept and take us back then to what, to the time when insurance companies had the power to deny people with pre-existing conditions? Well, we are not going back. We are not going back. We are not going back. Because we will move forward. Because ours is a fight for the future. And it is a fight for freedom. Like the fundamental freedom of a woman to make decisions about her own body. Government tell her what to do. And we remember how we got here. Donald Trump, when he was president, hand-selected three members of the United States Supreme Court with the intention that they would undo Roe. And they did as he intended, and now more than one in three women in America lives in a state with a Trump abortion ban, including right here in Arizona, 3.5 million women. And many of these bans, like the one in this state, have no exceptions even for rape and incest. It is immoral. And I know we all know one does not have to abandon their faith or deeply held beliefs to agree. The government should not be telling her what to do. Not the government. If she chooses, she'll talk with her priest or her pastor or her rabbi or her imam, but not the government. So, Arizona, we need to fight this battle on every front. And in this election, you have the chance on the state level to vote yes on Proposition 139. 139. And protect your right to make your own health care decisions. And then, when Congress passes a bill to restore reproductive freedom nationwide, as President of the United States, I will proudly sign it into law. Proudly. But look, in addition to that, you know, I'm traveling around the country and across our nation, guys, we are witnessing a full-on attack on hard-won, hard-fought freedoms and rights, fundamental freedoms and rights, like the freedom to vote, the freedom to be safe from gun violence, the freedom to love who you love openly and with pride. And the freedom to breathe clean air and drink clean water. A topic that looms large here in Arizona, and I know that topic well. I worked on drought resilience for years and helped secure historic resources for communities across the West to invest in water infrastructure, water recycling, and water storage. And I promise you, as president, I will continue to invest in drought resilience so that communities like those across Arizona have what you need to thrive. So look, so much is on the line in this election, 26 days to go. And this is not 2016 or 2020. The stakes are even higher. Because remember, a few months ago, the United States Supreme Court told the former president he is effectively immune from whatever he does in office. Now, because you all know, just imagine Donald Trump with no guardrails. He who has vowed if he were reelected, he'd be a dictator on day one. Who will weaponize the Department of Justice against his political enemies, and who has called for the, quote, termination of the Constitution of the United States of America. And let us be clear. Someone who suggests we should terminate the Constitution of the United States should never again stand behind the seal of the President of the United States of America. Never again. Never again. Never again. So it all comes down to this. Generations of Americans before us have led the fight for freedom, and now the baton is in our hands. The baton is now in our hands because we here know what is at stake, and we love our country. We love our country. We love our country. And I do believe one of the highest forms of patriotism. And one of the highest forms then of patriotism, of the expression of our love of our country, is to fight for the ideals of our country and to fight to realize the promise of America. So the election is in 26 days. Here in Arizona, early voting has already started statewide. You can cast your ballot today or any day between now and November 5th. So now is the time to make your plan to vote. And if you have received your ballot in the mail, please do not wait. Fill it out today. Return it in today. I think some of you have. Because, folks, the election is here. The election is here, and we've got to energize and organize and mobilize. And please, let's always remember, your vote is your voice, and your voice is your power. And so, Arizona, I ask you, are you ready to make your voices heard? Do we believe in the promise of America? And are we ready to fight for it?
as I meditate for practice. Channel 9 News tell me I'm moving backwards. 8 blacks left, death is around the corner. 7 misleading statements about my persona. 6 headlights waving in my direction. 5-0 asking me what's in my possession. Yeah, I keep running, jumping the aqua. There's fire hydrants and hazardous smoke alarms on the back of us. But mama, don't cry for me, ride for me, drive for me, live for me, breathe for me, sing for me. Honestly, guiding me, I can be more than I gotta be. Stole from me, lied to me, nation hypocrisy, code on me, driving me wicked. My spirit inspired me like, yeah. Open correctional gates in high desert. Yeah. Open our mind as we cast away oppression. Open the streets and watch our beliefs. And when they carve my name inside the concrete, I pray it forever reads.
Freedom, freedom, I can't move. Freedom, cut me loose. Freedom, freedom, where are you? Cause I need freedom too. I break chains all by myself. Won't let my freedom ride in hell. Hey, I'ma keep on running cause the winner don't quit on themselves.
Hello, everyone. This is Maya Harris. Thanks so much for inviting me as we all get ready to cheer on my sister for tonight's Univision Town Hall. And thank you all for all the support and love that you've given to my sister. I want to start by wishing everyone a happy Hispanic Heritage Month, because it goes without saying that the contributions of the Latino community to this country are invaluable. And I look forward to hearing Kamala talk about her vision for continuing to advance the community's priorities. The Latina community has always had my sister's back, and I know that Kamala has yours. And that's because of the values that we share, values that we grew up with, and how we were raised. Over the past few weeks, I've been traveling all around the country helping voters get to know Kamala, and as I've been out there talking to people, I've often said that to really know who Kamala is to know our mother, Shyamala Gopalan Harris, who we, of course, called Mommy. Some of you may know, our mother left India, the only country she'd ever known, as a teenager to pursue her education in the United States. She came here by herself, which was virtually unheard of in 1958, but when she got here, she found a community that embraced her. Well, Mommy raised Kamala and me to understand through word and deed that we all have so much more in common than what separates us, that we all want the same things for our children, for our families, for our communities, and that we can have different histories and different struggles and different perspectives, but the thing that binds us all together is a desire to be free, to fulfill our God-given potential. Kamala's entire life has been about fighting for each of us to have that freedom. Fighting to build a thriving, inclusive democracy where no matter where you are from, what you look like, where you come from, what neighborhood you live in, the language you speak, your accent, the religious practice that you may have, you all have opportunities that you deserve. Fighting for an America where we recognize that our differences are not a weakness, they're our greatest strength. And fighting for an America where we grow our economy by investing in the middle class. Because you see, we grew up in a middle class community. And we were raised to believe that every hardworking American should not only be able to find a good paying job, buy a home, or start a business, you should be able to build wealth and have something to pass on to your children. As Kamala says, to not just get by, but get ahead. That's who my sister is. That's who she's always been. And then there's Donald Trump and J.D. Vance, two people looking out for themselves, who'd rather give tax breaks to billionaires and big corporations than give every American an opportunity to succeed, who think they're more qualified than women to make decisions about our health, our families, and our futures, who'd rather divide this country than unite it, because they know that when the people come together, we have the power. So listen, we only have 26 days until Election Day. 26 days to make sure that people are registered and voting in numbers so overwhelming that there's no doubt about where the people stand. And I know everyone watching is already doing so much. And yes, tonight I am asking you to dig deeper and do some more, because we need to understand that even though our momentum is growing, Kamala is still the underdog in this race, and we cannot take anything for granted. This race is very, very close, and it will take all of us to get over the finish line. So your work, your individual effort, could be the margin of victory in your precinct. Your collective work can win this election. So I loved seeing Michelle Obama on the convention stage echoing another one of our mother's lessons. Don't wait to be asked, she said. Do something. And tonight, I'm going to add, for these next 26 days, it's not enough to just do something. We all need to do everything that we can. That is how we're going to make Kamala Harris the next president of the United States. So thank you all.
You contrast all that Kamala Harris wants to do for all of us with Donald Trump. We know that Donald Trump doesn't care about us. He only cares about himself and enacting retribution if he gets back into the White House. We know how dangerous his plans are. Economists have called his plans for the economy an inflation bomb. We also know that Trump's Project 2025 wants to end Social Security and Medicare, which is critically important to our communities. We also know his plan for immigration. While Kamala Harris has a sensible plan, she has said many times we can both have a secure border and have a humane immigration system, Donald Trump has talked solely about his mass deportation plan, something similar to what the Eisenhower administration created in the 1950s, where 60% of the people deported were U.S. citizens. His Project 2025 presents that kind of danger for all of us.
Saludos, mi gente. Yo soy Mireya Ramos. We have Jill Peacock on the keys, Trevor Turla on trombone, Cristian Rodriguez on the congas. We're so thrilled to be representing our communities. Cannot wait for this election, this historic one. Now, more than ever, we need love. We need people to come together, a leader that represents love. Hope you enjoy this music.
Sentimiento. Mm-hmm.